And the way you do that is by comparing your life to the scriptures. The book of 1 John is a good place to do that. It was written so that you may know that you have eternal life. And in the book of 1 John, it describes the characteristics of a genuine believer. One of the characteristics of a genuine believer is, are you sensitive to sin in your life? Is there a battle going on in your life over sin? 1 John says, if we have fellowship with him while we walk in darkness, we lie and do not practice the truth. But if we walk in the light as he is the light, we have fellowship with one another, and the blood of Jesus, his son, cleanses us from all sins. Another earmark of a genuine Christian is that they believe in Jesus Christ. They know who he is. They know that he is the Son of God. They know that he is God himself in the flesh. And they're looking to Christ alone for their salvation. They're trusting in him alone. Not trusting in any works of their own. 1 John says that everyone who believes that Jesus is the Christ has been born of God. Another earmark of a genuine Christian is that they practice righteousness. 1 John says, if you know that he is righteous, you may be sure that everyone who practices righteousness has been born of him. What that means is there's no habitual sinning in your life. Now, that doesn't mean that we as Christians still sin, because we do. Because we have this body of flesh that we still struggle with. But it means that there's a war going on inside. It means that the direction of my life is right. It means that I have stopped. It's like repentance. I have stopped. I have turned around. I start going the other direction. Instead of living my life in rebellion against God, I'm living my life for God. It means that that there's no habitual sinning, that we're living a life that's pleasing to God. Another earmark of a genuine Christian is that a genuine Christian does not love the world. 1 John says, do not love the world for the things of the world. If anyone loves the world, the love of the Father is not in him. A genuine Christian separates himself from the world. He loves the things of God, not the things of the world. Another earmark of a genuine Christian is they love others. 1 John says, we know that we have life because we love the brothers. Whoever does not love abides in death. Christianity is all about love, about loving our brothers. And it's about loving you guys enough to come out here and tell you the truth, to warn you that we're all going to face God on Judgment Day, that there's many on that day who are going to call themselves Christians, and Christ is going to say, depart from me, I never knew you. The Bible says that he who believes in the Son has eternal life, but he who does not obey the Son shall not see life, but the wrath of God abides on him. This is Easter weekend. We're celebrating the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ. Yesterday, Good Friday, Jesus went to the cross. He died for sinners. He lived the perfect sinless life, something that me and you cannot do. He went to the cross and died in our place, died in the place of sinners. And tomorrow, Easter Sunday, he rises from the dead, defeating sin and death. God is holy and righteous and just, and he must punish sin. But how can God be merciful and just at the same time? It's only through his Son, Jesus Christ. When Jesus takes our sin and puts it on him and gives us what we don't deserve, the righteousness of Christ, God can grant us eternal life. That's the good news. That's what it's all about. That's Easter. And my friend here, Steve, is going to come up and read to you from Scripture the account of the death, burial, and resurrection. We just ask that you would repent of your sin, examine yourself, look to Christ. Consider what we're talking about today. Do you know that you really believe? How do you know? Look at the Bible and compare yourself to the Scriptures. Thank you.